YouTube family, what's good? It's your boy Nico the Bob, and today we are back with yet another video. Guys, I know I haven't been around for 2 weeks. I haven't posted tutorials for the past 2 weeks. I do apologize. I did start a new hobby, and basically I didn't know how to manage my time. I was still figuring out. I was still trying to manage my time out, but I finally worked out the schedule, so that's all sorted. We are back to dropping weekly tutorials. So today what I have for you guys is a shadow fade. I did some scissor work and some styling. You'll hear me speak more about it in the tutorial. This one was super dope, super fun. It's not every day that I do get shadow fade, so I definitely had fun with it, had to record it, and now posting it up for you guys. So, if you are new to the channel, please go ahead and hit the subscribe button. Most importantly, smash the notification bell, because we are back with the weekly drops. And most also, leave a comment, let me know how you feel about the content. And most importantly, share, tell your friends. If you know anyone that is a barber, aspiring to become a barber, just let him know about the channel, that he can learn better his or her skills by watching the tutorials. And yeah. If you are looking for daily barbering content, you can go ahead and follow me on Instagram and Twitter at Enrico_thebarber. And yeah, let's go ahead, let's jump straight into today's tutorial.
As you can see, today we are doing the shadow fade full tutorial. So first things first, you guys know, as usual, we're gonna go ahead and comb our client's hair out. This is always my first step before starting any haircut. Then what we're gonna do is we're gonna go ahead and start with our number one guard, starting off with my magic clip lever closed, and all we're doing is we're setting in our first initial guideline. So basically with the shadow fade, you can use no guard lever open, or you can use a number one guard lever closed. It's all up to you. So my client wanted a number one guard with the lever closed, so I actually switched down to my wild designer, because my wild magic clip has been giving me some problems. I actually need to open it up and sort it out. Well, I actually opened it up a week ago, but still giving me the same problem. But nevertheless, my wild designer was here to save the day. So as you can see, all we're going ahead and doing is we're setting in our first initial guideline with our number one guard. And what I love about shadow fades, it's very simple and it's very easy to do, and to get a nice transition is very simple. Next off, I'm gonna go back with my number one guard, but now what we're gonna do is we're gonna set in another guideline. As you can see, I'm opening my lever, so now we are on our number one guard lever open, and all we're doing is we're setting in another guideline of about 1/2 inch. And the nice thing with the shadow fade is you don't really see any harsh transition lines when you're just beginning the fade. Like as you can see now, you can't really see the difference between the lever closed and the lever open. And once you got that guideline in, what we'll go ahead and do is we'll close our lever, and all we'll do is we'll soften up the guide and make sure that there is no line. So we'll make sure that it is transitioning smoothly into one another. Once we've smoothened out that, or got rid of our first initial guideline, what we'll go ahead and do is we'll put on our number two guard lever close. And what you'll see me doing is I'm really trying to flick out as I reach closer to the parietal ridge. All I do is I flick out. So as you can see, I'm not taking this guideline up too high, just bringing it straight. Yeah, just before the parietal ridge, you can say, and as soon as I reach it, I flick out. So I do this technique to make sure that I don't leave any harsh guidelines. Next off, I'm gonna go with my number 1.5 guard, starting off with my lever open, and all we're gonna do is we're gonna get rid of that that bottom guideline over there. So we'll start off with our lever open and we'll gradually work our way down to our lever closed. Now that we've softened up that guideline really nicely, we'll go back with our number one guard lever open, and all we'll do is we'll make sure that we get rid of that guideline we have created, make sure that we smoothen out the fade, and you'll already start noticing that our blend is starting to come together very nicely and everything's looking nice and sharp so far. So next off, I'm gonna jump to my wild detailers. What I like to do with my shadow fades is I don't like to focus on the fade throughout the cut. I like to take a small break and, you know, maybe work on my client's lineup in the back, on the sides. I basically do this just so that I can see if there are any dark spots or any inconsistencies in my fade. So when you do put the lineup in, it really makes the cut stand out more. So I really like to do this, but I start off by just trimming the back, lining up the back, and this already automatically allows me to see any inconsistencies or dark spots within my fade. And when you are lining your client up around the ear, always use your one hand to make sure that you have his ear nice and flat against his head, just so that you can round around the, make sure that you can round him up nicely around the ear. Once you're happy with that, we'll jump back to our number two guard. Start off with our lever open. And here you purely see me using a flick motion. I'm making use of my flick motion because I don't want to create a step basically. I want to make sure that my fade is blending nicely. I want to make sure that the top is blending into the sides, that we have a very nice and clean transition. So you'll notice that I am using a flick motion for majority of the step. Next off, we're gonna go back to our 1.5 guard. We're gonna start off with our lever open and we're basically gonna soften up all the dark spots we see. We're gonna make sure that we get a nice blend. So I'll start off with my lever open. I'll gradually work my way down to my lever being closed, and as you can see, I'm still working on the flick motion. You'll notice in the video I am continuously adjusting my lever from it being open to it being closed, and that's what I love. These are, like I said earlier in the video, these are one of the easiest fades to do. Shadow fades are really easy, and it's really difficult to actually mess up a shadow fade. Once you get the hang of it, it's super easy to do these cuts. You can get them done in 25-30 minutes. Once we're done with the 1.5 guard, we'll just go back to our number one guard, and now all we're gonna basically be doing is we're gonna be detailing, making sure we use the corners of our blades. Now you'll notice me continuously adjusting my lever from it being open down to it being closed, and you can already see from the steps that we have used, our fade is already looking really nice. Everything is blending into each other very nicely, and now all I'm doing is I have my lever closed and I'm basically just making sure that the bottom area is nice and even, making sure that I have no inconsistencies or any dark spots. Dream, 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 dream. Now for the next part, I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna wet my client's hair, because what we are gonna do is I'm basically gonna blend the side in. And yeah, so what I'm doing is I'm basically just putting some water on my client's hair, because we want to blend this area in over here on the side. So I'm basically styling his hair in the way that he would usually style his hair, so that the hair can be falling in place properly. And as you can see on the left hand side, he has a crown over there, and we'll dig deeper into that when we get there. Now all I'm doing is I'm grabbing the hair at a 90 degree angle, and what I'm doing is I'm cutting. And when you do use this technique, what it does is it creates a very smooth transition from the fade into the longer hair on the top. Because my client has a comb over type of a hairstyle, what we do is we make sure that on this side the hair is blending very nicely into the fade, because we don't want to have it hanging over the fade. So we want to make sure that we get a very nice blend with the top and the side. And as you can see, using that technique, it got it nice and clean. But what I will do is take my thinning comb, do some scissor over comb work, and as you can see, I'm angling my comb at a 90 degree angle as I scoop, just to make sure that I do not cut too much off. And now what we're gonna do is we're gonna go ahead and sort my client's lineup up. As you can see on the left hand side, he has a crown, so it's a bit more dense on the left hand side. So what we will do is, especially with clients that have these type of crowns, what you should do is you try and keep the hairline as natural as possible. Now I am using my Wild Detailers, and you guys know, if you are a regular viewer, I always start my lineups in the center. I either move to the left or to the right, and with these type of cuts I always try to keep my lineups as natural as possible. And I really do take my time with the lineup, as you would notice in majority of my tutorials. And if you are new to the channel, go ahead and hit the subscribe button. We are dropping weekly content, so if you are looking to learn more, better your skills, then definitely go ahead and hit the subscribe and the notification bell. Now what we're gonna go ahead and do is we're gonna do some razor work on the lineup. So you know, when we come through with the razor, we get the cut nice and crispy. Make sure we get the lines nice and sharp as well. As you can see, I'm keeping the lineup super natural as well. As you can see, this looks like a classic man's cut. It's a very, very nice gentleman's cut. So I want to make sure we keep it as natural, as clean as possible. And I really enjoy these type of cuts, because it's not every day that I get to style my client's hair. As you can see now, all I'm doing is I'm basically just setting my client's hair in the shape that it would be styled. I'm not too experienced with the blow dryer. I really want to actually work towards bettering my skills with blow drying, styling. And all I'm doing is I'm using a matte wax, and I'm gonna go ahead and style my client's hair the way he would usually style it. And I really had fun with this cut, because like I said, it's not every day I get these type of cuts that come through the door, so really enjoy to get more of these as well. I just enjoy the full service, the styling, the cut, the style. Yeah, super dope. Like give your own specific touch, like with the styling. You know, your client will style his hair a specific way, but you as the barber, you'd see it another way, and you could suggest it to him, or just the way you'd like to see his hairstyle. So yeah, I really enjoy styling. As you can see, I'm making sure I'm getting everything nice and in place. And because of his crown, you'll notice that the one side, it seems as if his hair is leaning more to the left, you can say. But it really suits him, it looks good. And one thing with the shadow fade, what I am gonna do next is I'm gonna go back to my wild designers, and all I'm gonna do is, instead of creating a straight line or rounding my client up at the back, what I prefer doing is I prefer tapering it out. I prefer giving it a nice blend at the back over here. I feel like it looks much cleaner this way instead of the boring just squared off line. So yeah, just to give the cut a bit more of a pop, I prefer to taper the back out. I'm coming through with the detailer, making sure I get rid of all the baby hairs in my client's neck. And guys, this is what my client Kevin looked like before we got the cut in, and this is how he looked as soon as we're done with the cut. Got him nice and lined up, and as you guys know, I don't really put too much beard work due to lighting. But anyway, this is the final cut, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed today's tutorial. If you are new to the channel, please go ahead and hit the subscribe button, definitely smash the notification bell, leave a like, comment, interact with me, let me know how you feel about the content. Until the next video, peace.